Neben mir steht ein Teil von Is Tropical, a part of Is Tropical is next to me now. Welcome to the show.
Hello, thank you for having me and us.
The show was kind of bright daylight. Do you like that, performing when it's still bright outside?
Luckily we were in a tent, so Howie, who does our lights, could smash it and get it really dark and put the strobes on.
But the whole atmosphere is still very, it's a day atmosphere, isn't it?
No, we changed it, man. I feel sorry for the band that came on after us, because we turned it into midnight when we were there. We brought some demons down.
Do you know which band is performed after you?
No idea.
You don't?
Was it someone really good, like Tom Petty?
Actually, I don't know it as well.
I bet it was Bon Jovi, and I'm just embarrassing myself.
You don't like Bon Jovi?
I love Bon Jovi.
You do?
Yeah.
I hate Bon Jovi.
Well, he was one of the only artists that performed with Anvil. You know Anvil?
Yes.
My favorite metal band. So he was lucky.
That's the reason why.
That's right, yeah.
Okay, I have to translate. Is Tropical haben heute gespielt im Intro-Zelt. Da ist es eigentlich natürlich dunkel, aber es war recht früh am Tag. Es war 19 Uhr. Das heißt, da ist ja trotzdem Tagesatmosphäre, aber nein, das stört überhaupt nicht. Für Is Tropical war es halt wirklich, die haben das Ganze zu einer Mitternachtsshow gemacht und es lief wunderbar. Ein bisschen schade für die Band, die danach kam, weil die kann das auf keinen Fall toppen. So, do you differ when you stay on stage of a festival or if you go to the club, yeah? Because it is not your original crowd in front of the stage, for example.
Yeah, we feel more comfortable playing really late at night in clubs where everybody's on drugs, but we try and bring a little bit of that to a festival when we play too.
Yeah.
And I think that people in the festival, they bought a ticket, they want to have a good time, so it's just as easy to create an atmosphere there as anywhere, you know?
Okay, so it's not a difference.
No, I mean, you know, you could play in your friend's mum's front room, but if there was the right people there, then it would be like a club, you know?
Have you ever done that? Playing in front of your friend's mom's room?
We've played in the back of a kebab shop before.
Okay.
We've played in some pretty interesting places.
I know, you still with lots of exhibitions, for example, you played at. So this is really a different audience if you compare that to audience at an exhibition, for example.
Yeah, this is our first time in Melt and we heard a lot about it.
What did you hear?
We heard that it's one of the best festivals in Europe. And even though we played at like, what, 7 o'clock, we weren't disappointed. It was brilliant. It was really good.
Also Is Tropical haben schon viel über das Melt-Festival gehört. Sie waren noch nie hier, es ist das erste Mal. Aber es wurde alles bestätigt, dass es wirklich ein fantastisches Festival ist. I read on Twitter that you are looking for a harp.
Yeah.
Did you find it?
Somebody offered an auto harp.
Yeah.
But that's kind of not the same thing. That's where you push a button down and then you strum a chord.
Yeah.
But I think... We just want to sample things like how Wu-Tang did, you know?
Okay.
But we'll find one eventually. Okay. We asked for an organ a few months ago, and we got 4 organs sent to our house. So we were doing like, you know, Rush, where they have an organ there and an organ there.
You can have them all the time at the same time.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Synchronized. Yeah. That's fun. Is Tropical haben auf Twitter gefragt nach einer Harfe, die sie brauchen für die Band. Da ist noch nicht viel passiert, da haben sie ein Sampling-Gerät bekommen, aber sie haben vor einigen Wochen gefragt nach einer Orgel und da kamen völlig unaufgefordert auf einmal 4 Orgeln direkt ins Haus der Band geliefert. So Twitter's a perfect way to get new instruments. It's a bit a trend, you know, for example, Crystal Fighters, they also play with harps or Florence at the Machine to put some synthy sounds together with some very classical instruments.
I think that like the whole synthesizer thing, and everybody attributed that to being an 80s revival, and I think, you know, a band like Rat-A-Tat are a good example of using organic sounds in electronic music and dance music. I don't think you should be limited to just using artificial sounds, you know, like in one of our songs we have we use a bit of a TV, or we use the sound of a dog, or whatever sounds good, you know.
The dog still sounds like a dog, or do you just use the dog as a sound and then you form that?
We put the dog through about 500,000 different kinds of pedals.
So it doesn't sound like a dog anymore?
No, okay. Hopefully not.
But what kind of sound is the next sound? Because in what kind of direction does it go now?
I think music is moving towards a more skeptical period. I think people are just interested in good songwriting rather than stylistic intent.
Yes.
I think bands a few years ago, and maybe some are still going now, are more interested in their identity instead of, you know, the music that they make. And they're marketed in that way.
Yes.
And that model's dead. Record labels are on their way out. And I think people are just deciding, well, you know, if the ship's sinking, I might as well write a really good song before it goes down, you know?
Ich habe gerade mal nachgefragt, in welche Richtung der Sound geht. Also es geht schon so in, es kommen wieder organische Instrumente rein, aber auch dieses ganze Selbstmachen, labellos sein als Band, das passiert auch nach und nach immer weiter. Of course, we saw the video for the Greeks, but we have to talk about that because we are not allowed to broadcast that on German television. Yeah, it's a, quite a bit of love, but actually it's serious. Ganz kurz noch zum Video The Greeks von Estropical. Das können wir bei Pop 10 leider nicht zeigen, weil man muss ganz kurz erklären, dort gibt es Kinder, die spielen mit Wasserpistolen, aber das ist dann so drüber gezeichnet im Comic-Stil, wie sie dann quasi andere Menschen umnieten, bis hin zur eigenen Oma. So, but the thing is, what really interested me is the script done by the kids or their own ideas, because I think it's kind of hard to let, for example, 8 or 9 year old kids or 10 year old kids shoot their own grandmas, even though maybe they don't think it is real shooting because they are playing with water pistols. I don't know, how much did they know about the video?
Basically, all of the action that happens in that video, with the exception of a couple two little conventional scenes that you see, that's all self-directed. Those kids were allowed to play, and then we turned their imagination into reality.
Okay, that's very interesting. Also es ist wirklich so, die Kinder haben quasi nur die Mittel bekommen und haben dann selbstständig gespielt. Und das, was ihr seht im Video zu The Greeks, wir haben euch das im Blog auf pop10.de mal verlinkt, im Fernsehen dürfen wir es leider nicht zeigen, das haben sie alles selbst gemacht. Das wurde dann bloß halt quasi nochmal umgedreht, quasi das, was sie im Kopf haben, wurde also als Bild gezeigt, das Video gezeigt. So the kids were kind of satisfied with the video clip?
The kids had the best day of their lives, probably.
Okay.
And how lucky are they, you know, like... When I was younger and I was running around with my friends shooting them with water pistols, it didn't look that good. There wasn't explosions and blood everywhere. So their dream came true just for a little bit of time. So big shout out to Megaforce for making that video. They smashed it.
Okay, also die Kinder haben auch quasi sowas wie ihre beste Zeit gehabt. Endlich wurde mal das, was sie im Kopf immer haben, wirklich wahr. Yeah, it's German television, you know. It's not so easy to bring that on prime time.
Yeah. You can look it up online, I'm sure.
We link that.
But you have to be over 18.
What is the favorite thing to do tonight for you? Watching bands? What kind of bands? Did you check the schedule? What happened?
Unfortunately, because we had to do promo, we're going to miss Nicolas Jaar. I wanted to see Nicolas Jaar play. We're going to see our good friends Crystal Fighters. And then I think we're going to go up on one of those cranes and try and find something to ruin our bodies. So that tomorrow is a difficult day going home.
Okay. Also morgen wird ein anderer Tag nach diesem Melt-Festival für Estropical. Crystal Fighters steht auf dem Plan, der Kran steht auf dem Plan.